So no surprise on the Killister ban. Now follow up into Freddy. Freddy had great games last week in memberships, the Gnar into Shen and then Shen into Gnar. And definitely looking like a lot stronger force. Jankos as well showing up last week a little more. Sven, a lot of these players who used to be so, so good are now finding their feet again in summer.
So is Rocket going to go for a Sivir first pick or predict that SK will ban it out and then just pick up the early Gragas? Wondering. However, Rocket has also been fine with trading Lee Sin for Gragas in the past. Maybe they say tier 1 Rek'Sai, tier 1.5 Gragas, and we play a mean Lee Sin, so we put that ourselves on tier 1.5. So we want to see where Sivir ends up.
And the question is, will Nukeduck run the likes of Varus again? We've seen Jace has been banned out against Nukeduck since the changes, and it is going to be that first pick Sivir.
Early Varus could be possible from SK Gaming. They say, okay, you want the traditional early rotation pick, but we ban out one of the two superior poke champs right now. We get rid of the Jace and we pick up the Varus early. Could be an adaptation being made in the metagame. I think we're a little early for that. I think next week we'll see people more play around poke a little more as the win percentage keeps rising up.
And of course, last week when Rocket played against Copenhagen Wolves, they had a first pick Sivir, second rotation got Echo and Varus. Echo is available. Varus is available. They've also run Gragas when they ran Varus the day before. So for Rocket, the ingredients of the poke comp that won them games last week is available. Will they be allowed to cook another victory? Or will SK try to deny it?
Sprinkle some salt on it.
There's the first, at least one of the tools, if that Echo gets locked in. Sven's run it in the jungle. And it was the first time Sven looked good in summer. Playing that Echo, he had the gank from the Wraith camp over the wall with that phase dive, and it is locked in.
So SK Gaming locking in the Shen and the Echo here. Usually we don't see an early Shen that often. They want to deny the Echo in the top lane. Lock it in for their jungle. Say, okay, we can play it into anything. Get your Gragas, we don't care. Double hard engage into a very mobile Rocket Gaming lineup. Even though we've only seen 1 out of 5 picks, we already know it's going to be a lot of mobility just because of On the Hunt, and which is why Sivir is such a staple pick right now. Gragas, you usually lock in the jungle right here, even though you could wait, because you don't want to give away any more information. Rocket have still not decided if they're running poke comp. This might be the Nautilus top, by the way. I'm still waiting for Europe to unleash that horror.
Well, Pulse will be very excited to hear that. Challenger caster and aficionado of top lane Nautilus. I think Jat said last week, the best thing about Nautilus top on your team is that you have Nautilus on your team. We'll find out where that cookie does crumble. There is options there for Rocket. There is also the option to run the Varus. There's a lot of disengage that could come from Nautilus, whether he's top or support.
I mean, Varus, Janna, Corki could run out this composition pretty well for SK Gaming. And the question is, which one of those are you going to pick up early? Probably, I wouldn't mind seeing a Varus, Janna in this rotation. Just leave the Corki up. I mean, Rocket is not going to pick the Janna way, but they opt for a different style. They don't want to play poke. They say, okay, we just want to go for these heavy team fights. A lot of damage coming out. Cassiopeia, so much damage per second. Candy Pan out of Tristana, if she gets going, she can do a whole lot of damage too, but relatively low mobility on Cassiopeia and a couple of threats already that we spot on Rocket. Spell Shield for the ultimate. Nautilus R and Q is enough to lock her down. Gragas can Body Slam Flash, so this game will have to be careful.
Well, last time we saw some of these less mobile team comps, they also seem to struggle. Unicorns of Love comes to mind as one of the teams that's tried a similar sort of composition, but it's not worked out. For Rocket, they could play poke. Varus into Cassio, also a matchup that's worked several times. It was, in fact, against Unicorns of Love that Rocket won last week.
And something that's a little odd, because we've seen it in NA, but this is the first Tristana over in Europe, according to our stats person, Spellzy.
Thanks, dude.
Always whispers in our ear with beautiful statistics.
Sweet nothings of information.
Maokai, Rocket. They're trying to prove me wrong. They're like, Okrepo, your entire segment in the opening of A Block is around how Maokai has fallen off and just picked by these lower tier teams, and every team is like, no, Maokai is fine. You're wrong.
Statistically speaking, Rocket's not necessarily up there just yet. 4-6. However, 5 wins, 12 losses. That is the stat line for Maokai. He had an extra loss this morning. Can Rocket demonstrate a superior lane swap or superior lane decision-making than we saw from our previous matchup from the Copenhagen Wolves? Lost support, will be locked in. It's going to be Morgana for Enraged.
Yeah, Morgana with Black Shield stops the engage. I like it into the likes of Maokai for sure. You can still block the Varus Ultimate too. You can block that Dredge Line. You can block everything from Nautilus. Black Shields will be crucial. SK Gaming have two threats and an Echo in the jungle, who normally builds pretty tanky. So two damage threats that they have to keep alive. Rocket at the same time, two damage threats as well, of which one is Poke. So in a straight up burst team fight, they're actually relatively low on damage. Especially in the mid game, they're okay. But later on as the game progresses, yes, Sivir has good late game teamfight damage, but will it be enough? Cassio is such a force to be reckoned with.
Crucial to see how positioning and vision plays out in this particular game. Knowing that all the poke is going to hurt a lot. And also knowing Shen's going to be looking to try split push.
Yeah.
Freddy's definitely shown a penchant for trying to control those side lanes and then joining his team when needed. You'll see those team comps one more time. Both of these teams looking for wins. 3-7 for SK versus 4-6 for Rocket.
And then, yeah, if you have an idea of who's going to win this game, tweet at LOL Esports, hashtag RSC win or hashtag SK win. Crowd is excited. Ah, the bromance.
Anypan and Enraged back on the stage, reunited in summer as we load into the Rift against Rocket. We will be seeing whether Maokai can score a goal for Rocket or whether he'll give away a red card and let SK trample all over him.
The football references.
Didn't really work.
Not soccer.
I'm not going to lie. It didn't really work.
It's fine.
But I committed and I just sort of went all in.
Good old football reference is fine for me. That's what we call it in Europe. Not hand egg.
Hand egg.
All right, let's talk about matchups real quick. Sivir and Nautilus, they can if they get the push advantage, they're fine. However, they're playing against double ranged with Tristana Morgana, so they might actually want to swap. They get that lane swap ward out. Then again, we've seen Maokai not do too well in these lane swaps lately.
Well, he'll help if he's got some support.
Oh, Freddy.
Wasn't Vanda.
Barking up the wrong tree.
There's no root available. Just that little sapling. We'll get some bonus. And another ward secured.
Shh, nope, we're not doing that over in Europe. We cheer for blood, not for wards. All right, Rocket invading, putting the standard deep wards. SK mirroring it. And yeah, see some stats from the last matchup.
SK denied the fifth dragon because the game simply ended before them. They got that Baron, I remember distinctly, and just steamrolled Rocket. But let's also be fair. SK are looking stronger a few weeks down the line, as are Rocket. Both teams improving themselves.
Very important. Freddy gets spotted. They do that a lot. SK Gaming's traditional lane swap was with Freddy in the top lane trying to soak up XP. And Vander, they knew he was coming, so they just tried to deny him entry. You shall not pass.
Not as threatening as the Balrog yet. Maybe once he gets that Sunfire Cape picked up, it'll be a little scarier.
Yeah, he joins the Conga line with the minions. Both teams doing golems.
So what we do need to highlight is Sven Skjern's gank pathing. Last time he did play on Echo, he went for a relatively early mid lane gank.
Watch how they're spreading out this AoE on the Krugs. Beautiful mastery. Very efficient in terms of time spent doing them. Okay, solid Krug game.
Never ever gonna stop being exciting for you, Krepo.
I love it.
I do want to touch on Jankos, despite the fact his low win percentage on Gragas. Last week, he really had a great impact in the game. Extremely active and extremely powerful in getting Rocket ahead.
Now it's too late for SK to base and help out Freddy in the top lane. They can't make it up there in time anymore. Will Rocket go for the immediate dive? How is that top lane wave going right now? And will we see it roam anybody else?
All of these questions, when will we find out the answers?
Now.
Shortly. Enraged level 2. He's trying to run down Nuketuck. Nuketuck's moving into the river. He's going to flash away from the dark binding. Fox and Enraged forced to defensively flash away. Steven Jankos saved Nuketuck's life.
Now this is good for SK Gaming because Freddy in the top lane, he's getting a wave pushed in. And there is no dive threat as of yet. They really need to deny him some experience, else he's going to snowball ahead of Steven. But he needs backup.
Okay, we need to take a look at the summoner spells that have been blown. Fox, Flash Ignite, as well as Enraged Flash on the side of Rocket, Nuketuck, Jankos, and Steve all use their summoners. We need to see how that pans out the next few minutes.
Yeah, good. I like this adaptation from Rocket. Usually, you expect teams that start on their strong side to move into the enemy jungle and then go for the straight dive on the top lane. But because that wave was being pushed slow enough, it allowed for a bit of a scenic route. Drive by the mid lane and see if you can get a kill right there. SK were doing the same. Kind of surprising to see that much action in the mid lane. Usually, something we saw maybe like 3/4 of a year ago where supports are roaming to a mid, but as of late, we haven't seen it too much. All in all, relatively standard start once we progress a couple of minutes.
I want to see how well Fox can handle Cassiopeia. Specifically because when Rocket beats Unicorns of Love last week, it was against a Cassiopeia who also ran Flash Ignite. And Power of Evil was unable to find targets to stick to. He was unable to get past that range poke that Varus is putting down. And Fox this time may have similar difficulties.
Now the one thing that speaks in favor of this Rocket Maokai that they picked up is that both Cassiopeia and Tristana are single target damage that have issues switching up damage in teamfights. So if they play against a lot of tanks and they can't really kill one target really quickly and they have to switch, then having some tanks in there is pretty good because and no AoE on the side of SK Gaming makes it very hard to deal with a lot of these tanks because you kind of have to focus them to actually kill them, and that's going to cost you too much time and you'll die in the process.
Well, where the minion wave is right now is favorable for SK Gaming. You can see Sven hanging out by that Raptor camp. The long range engage of that parallel convergence and phase dive flash could get Sven to the no flash Nidra, but instead he's going on a little bit of a detour of his own. Steve still holding the hand of Vanda and Mr. Rawls.
He is simply waiting for that wave to get pushed in top and then he'll likely teleport up there to get up the farm. There's a little bit of a dive threat from Echo. So that's one possibility. But it's hard to dive in Maokai, mostly because he can like dodge a lot of damage with that Twisted Advance. In terms of Echo, usually we see Echoes gank from behind, you dash one step over the wall with the phase dive and then proc the second part, which makes your auto attack a gap closer. It's really good against flashless targets.
So let's quickly look at the top lane. Steve, even in levels with Freddy, even in CS, he got back up to lane in the 1v1. We do see Jankos falling slightly further behind Sven Skaren. I think Jankos has gone on a few more detours as Sven's not left the jungle yet.
Yeah, and in terms of AD carry itemization, playing pickaxe into pickaxe favors the Sivir, in my opinion, because it just allows you to clear the waves quickly with AoE enough that the counter damage from SK is not that high because a BF sword on a Tristana can just do so much damage real quickly. It's too brutal to try and challenge those waves. Pickaxe into pickaxe delays that poke and I feel it adds more value to your abilities that you have. You see Sven's grin.
Oh, I think he's going to interrupt this. Jankos gets caught out and stunned. Sven is jumping
block
forward.
The body slam.
We do see the body slam. Not going to allow Jankos to get away. Sven's grin's waiting for cooldowns. Gets the third proc. But
Red
Steve roots Sven Skirin in place. Timewinder goes out. And Steve saves Jankos.
Wait, I have to look at something real quick. Keep talking, Trevor.
Yes, sir. Jankos finally going to finish that recoil. Recall. As we do see Sven going back into his own jungle. So we take a quick look bottom lane. Mr. Rolls not using his mana to push the wave out just yet.
Oh my god.
A lot of minions pushing forward. Kripa, I think.
Yeah, sorry, I'm stuck in
a replay of that.
I'm stuck in the past. But Svenskrin's red buff expired in his flash animation. He wanted to flash auto and let the red buff finish off Jankos, but it expired just as he flashed. That was pixel frame perfect almost. And he would have gotten the kill if it wasn't for that annoying red buff expiring.
Parallel convergence is gonna get connected. Sven Skaren doesn't pop it, but Steve, after saving his teammates, gets taken out by Sven and Freddy for first blood.
Yeah, good return gang. But first you don't succeed. Try again. As Jet once said, let's see it right here. Sven Skaren goes over. It's all nice and dandy. This is good, because he interrupts the recall, then he blocks the body slam. Just keep watching right now. Red buff is on. Red buff is still on. It's on. Flash. Oh, it's gone, guys. Yep. That's the second tick of a previous red buff. That's not a new application, so this is... This is what Tilt is made of.
Hashtag just Tilt him.
Just Tilt him, boys. All right, back into the game. Very close game, as we see Nuketok. Yeah, he sniped that. I think he just stole that.
It's his blue on his side.
Oh yeah, okay, I'm confused.
Too excited!
Just killed the caster, boys. He steals his own blue buff! But now no play. All right, poke
hurts. Been a while since I've heard that one. We need to step back and look at the game. SK got first blood, they've traded towers top and bottom, and we're actually seeing Candy Panda with a big CS advantage pushing Mr. Riles in. as we see Sven Enraged stealing away the red buff this time around.
Yeah, Rockcat's putting pressure on the top side of the map, and this is what they did last week. They snowballed Steve, and they want to get him ahead. Right now, even though he got put behind just a little bit, and this opens up the map on the bottom side for SK Gaming. Look, they can dive over this wall, and Nuketech might be in trouble.
Nuketech does have Flash and Cleanse, but he's got two forms of CC to deal with if Enraged and Sven had gone in. But I think something Rocket should be aware of. We knew that Sven likes to gank from the camp, and Escape starts a dragon.
Yeah, but I feel like yielding the bottom side of the map is not the correct move for Rocket here. There's no point in trying to gank a Shen at this point, not with a Maokai. If you have a damage top laner, maybe. Charging arrow.
Not going to connect. Sven secures that one with a Time Winder and Smite, and stole away that red buff as well. So it's SK that come out ahead after the initial lane swap. Reset the lanes into sort of standard 2v2, 1v1, and it's SK with the lead.
And the better vision control on SK's side. Look at those wards in the enemy jungle. Double pink ward around mid as well. These poke champions often stay in the mid lane very often. They don't hide in the brushes for the assassinations like assassins usually do, because they just want to sit in the lane, poke, poke, poke. And this allowed SK to sneak two pink wards in, one on each side. Still take that play, and now Jankos is trying to gank, but it obviously gets spotted by the pink ward. Yes, he kills it, but it buys more time for Fox to get going.
Candy Panda's doing very well this game. You know, his league average is to be down 7 CS at 10 minutes. He's currently up 7. And it's on a champion that we don't see very often in Europe, if at all.
He needs the resets. That's what he wants in these fights. And Steve is put relatively far behind. He's not doing too well. 36 CS here at 10 minutes. Oh, he might actually be a target that they can focus, because he's going for Rice's Glory. An engage build that puts him a little ahead of his team. Same time, allows him to get bursted down. And yeah, one reset is all Candy Panda needs.
That's what you talked about, Crepa. The single target that Cassiopeia and Tristana can put out. If they can burn through Steve, then burn through Jankos.
Oh, here we go.
Nothing standing. Nuketech should get away, and he does. Sven's still hungry for an engage, but he's going to find both Vanda and Jankos. And he has the red buff.
Has another red buff.
That should time out shortly, I think. No, I'm lying. He actually picked up his own one.
Yeah.
A couple of minutes ago, I just caught a glimpse of that cooldown. Yeah, Steve, on the other hand, is actually 10th for CS at 10. Crapo. Lowest or the largest deficit down.
Now, that obviously goes back to his initial performance in the earlier week, because Steve has seen a bit of a rise in terms of play and split push. Although this time they put him on a tank. Not sure if I like that. That was one of our bullet points coming to this week. Rockcat, they're playing with split push on Steve, and it worked. Now they put him on Maokai, champion that I'm personally not the biggest fan of in the European meta right now. And Freddy, he's actually a very potent split pusher himself, so they kind of gave it to him. Yeah. They're not playing a split push champion into Freddy, playing a tank, and he likes doing that. Now with that Shen, got those Bami Cinder finished.
Freddy was one of the best split pushing top laners of last year. And the fact that Shen is seeing a little more play, at least here in Europe, it's definitely going to play into Freddy's hands. Enraged and Candy Panda, BF Sword and Pickaxe, waiting around the edge. They've got all summoners and ultimates available.
Yeah, and they have good vision control right now, too. We haven't seen Enraged group too much, so Fox connects.
Oh, Jankos is down. Not over yet. Vanda's in trouble. They need some auto attacks on that explosive charge, but that was just... There's that vision that you were talking about, Crepo.
Yeah, and another engage here on Valus. He wants to pop the ulti. Goes low, a little bit too much. But as I was talking, I wanted to say that I'd like to see SK group their jungler and their support together, get vision and make picks. Apparently, they didn't need their support. They found a good opening, good ultimate from Fox. Quick follow-up from Svenskeren, and SK are now 2 kills to none. And Svenskeren, he's making that jungle his own.
2 kills, a dragon, even on towers. Sven is now looking for Nuketech. He's gonna phase dive in. Look at the damage from that Time Winder. And in reply, piercing arrow does not connect. So Mr. Nuketech down 17 CS against Fox. But Fox, no flash available. So if Rocket were to engage, they could in theory chop off the head of the snake.
Yeah, and Svenskeren, I believe, not opting to pick up that early. Gragas says, we value Echo higher, mostly because it's a steal from Steve. Actually, end up liking that pick. It's making that jungle Echo work. However, jungle Gragas.
So we see the root comes down onto Freddy. Jankos does not have explosive cast. Shadow Dash Taunt will keep Freddy alive long enough to flash to safety and buy time for Sven to join the fights. Successful gank for Rocket. They got the summoner spell.
Yes and no. Last week, we saw Jankos gank for Rocket, for Steve in the top lane. And they got the kills every time because Steve had damage. Now Steve doesn't have enough damage to make that work, and it's too slow of a play. And SK can capitalize. Either they waste enough time on the top lane, or they get control of the bottom side of the map. And I don't like this identity where you play around your top laner, but you put him on a tank. When you're playing a tank jungle yourself, it used to work with double Cinder Hulk on top and mid, but Cinder Hulk on top lane has got nerfed a little bit. It's not that strong. Now look at Steve. Yeah, he's Murkred's Catalyst, but that's not a player you want to gank for at the moment. You want to try and snowball the other lanes. Rocket, we're 40 minutes into the game. We've yet to see an On the Hunt being used for grouping up.
Yeah, and that's something that we see out of the bottom half teams in Europe. When they do run Sivir, they often don't group effectively. Svenskjern, again looking to invade. I distinctly remember 2 weeks ago talking about the jungle buffs that Svenskjern and SK had stolen. And it looks like they're up to it again. That smites it away from Jankos as the Dark Binding doesn't connect. Spence looking for the shield. He chrono breaks backwards. He's going to get the parallel convergence onto one as Stand United continues to keep Svenskjern alive. Jankos is jumping for the Chain of Corruption. Will hold Candy in place. A long range twisted advance will throw Steve into the back lines. The eventual Maelstrom continues to prevent that damage. And Rocket get 2-for-1. They want Fox next. And Svenskjern is still alive. It started with Sven. It ends with Sven in a 2-for-3.
Chaos, chaos everywhere. What a fight in the jungle. Svenskjern stuck around a little bit too long, but he had faith in his teammates. And if you have faith, that's why you're here. That's why you're in the jungle. Shen came in, but just wasn't enough. And eventually, Rocket, repetitive damage, came out on top. Maokai, good flash, twisted advance from Steve. Forced Candy Panda out of the fight, and then synchronized flashing, 10 out of 10. We had the synchronized flash Olympics come in. Rocket would have scored pretty highly here. Not under a tower, so no synchronized diving. Yes, let's watch that.
That's a mini game I'd like to watch. Here's that fight once more.
So Svenskjern, he loses the blue, the red buff, and yeah, his pride is hurt. So he's like, no, okay, I'm fighting this. I'm fighting my way out of it. Even though they have spreading a split push, second time, where in my opinion, SK going a little bit too far. It procs that parallel conversion beautifully and then lands Freddy, but they're focusing the support and the carries are still alive, and this allows Nuketuk to enter. Look at that Varisulti. It spreads to two or three targets, and then Steve just peels the backline off, and this keeps Nuketuk alive. No forward threat anymore from SK Gaming. And watch Nuketuk. He doesn't panic flash over. He's probably telling his team, like, right now, I have flash, I have flash. The same way I think he played Aurelia mid once, and he was calling to his team. It's like, I can flash on Ezreal. Synchronized flash right there, engage, and they take down the Cassiopeia. And I feel this is a bit of a mistake from SK Gaming that we saw last week as well against Elements. They had the split push component going. They could have yielded. The objective was gone or no longer under pressure, but they decided to commit anyways. And bit of a mistake in my opinion.
And the SK pay for it. They lose the mid turret, they lose the team fight, and it looks like Rocket have got better vision, at least in the river, for this next dragon. We'll see whether or not they're willing to contest. Mid bottom lane is being pushed into the tower as well. So Rocket have closed that gold lead, 700, yep. And they're staying grouped around the objective. Teleport is up for both top laners.
And look at how Jankos and Vander are grouping, whereas we don't see Svenskjern and Raider do that at all this game. I feel that's what you have to do in the current meta. Eventually you want the Sivir to push in, rotate, and then you use the On the Hunt for, you know, plays around the map, just group up. Is that Sivir R? Worked for Rocket in the last fight. It allows Steve to close that gap. However, he is pretty squishy still.
I want to see how Rocket use the vision they've just placed in Dragon. Ideally, they are looking to poke, of course, Nuketuk's Varus, and if they want to run somebody down when they're low, they can with Mr. Riles, but it really frustrates me when teams invest so much time and energy into placing the wards and don't defend them, so that's when I see if Rocket can maintain control. Riles pushing bottom lane.
At least you get information and advise you time. If people are stuck spending time killing your pink ward, you may have time to push out the side lanes. It is just, everything in League of Legends right now is quid pro quo. You just want to get something. If they take something from you, you want to get something in return. And if you don't do that, that means you've made a mistake in the past, setting up the play wrong. Rocket, they want this pink ward. SK, they want to push top lane.
So advantages in CS for Freddy, for Fox. It's continuing to grow, but it's not necessarily affecting the gold values. Look at SK grouping once again towards Dragon. There is wards behind them if Steve wants to jump in. There you go. Sven's just walked straight over it.
Yeah, and that's a good point, Trevor. You really want those wards behind enemy lines to get that teleport flank in. Because if you can connect the Maokai to Cassiopeia, the fight should be won. Just pile on her, kill her, and then the only damage threat left is Candy Panda, who is fully single target damage, so very easy to take down in fights.
Alright, so Dragon once again, primary focus. We're seeing Candy Panda defending the bottom tower. We're also seeing Steve defending the top tower. This stalemate of a Dragon Dance.
It's because they only have one poke component on Rockat. Usually we see double poke take control of these objective areas, and then the repetitive poke is enough to force people out, but right now it's all on Nukeduck. He has to land like 4 arrows in a row. Almost like Febivin last week on Jace, landed all those shock blasts over and over and over. That doesn't really happen, and SK can stick around long enough to contest the vision, and the game kind of slows down right now. We saw a relatively explosive fight in the jungle, but teams are a little scared right now.
And I think important to note, Fox also just picked up that Rylai's Crystal Scepter as his next big item purchase. Still a little bit of gold, 1,500 for Freddy and Steve to go back and spend. 1,600 for Mr. Roll, so we'll most likely see him grabbing Zeal. Makings of most likely a Phantom Dancer, I believe. As we've seen Rolls do when there's a lot more wave clear on his team. And Sven, once again, with an aggressive invade. Sven is nothing if not consistent when invading.
No, he plays well when his lanes are pushing and he has some pressure to work with. I think he's a fantastic jungler in terms of counter jungling. And he's also Yanko's Kryptonite. Challenge for the blue buff.
No, Smite battle goes back and forth. That was secured by Nukeduck on the piercing arrow. And Sven is going to use the phase dive.
That was pretty sick. That was really sick. So he dashes out of the body slam with phase one of phase dive, but then realizes the explosive cask is going to knock him back. So he chrono breaks back in time to dodge that and allows Yankos to knock him out. Or he dashes out, rather. Thought that was a chrono break. However, he stayed alive. That's the most important thing. He almost got caught again, though.
Yeah. Also something we find ourselves saying about Svenskin very often, Kremlin. So, Dragon has been initiated. Teleport's available. Keep your eyes on those top laners in the minimap. I don't think it's going to be contested.
Rocket is grouped. They need to start using that Sivir ulti somehow. Find an opening. Because they're getting pressured on. We talked about those wards earlier that they had deep inside the jungle of SK. They have now expired and continuously been put under pressure.
21 minutes, 1,000 gold separates these teams, but SK have 2 dragons up, where Rocket have 1 additional tower. Rocket spent all of that time around the dragon objective, only to respond slowly and not secure the objective, or even challenge for it. I want to see how they alter their game plan, because as it stands, farming is the name of the game.
Yeah, but I feel like time is in SK's favor right now. 2 dragons. Almost becomes a style of them. Whereas last season, I felt they had less dragons, just more tower push. Now they've been taking up a lot of dragons. A couple of games, we've talked about how SK is 3-0 in dragons, 4-0 in dragons, and they're looking to repeat that. Okay, they're finally looking for a pick or a bit of a flank as they use that mid lane pressure to snowball that into the bot lane. See if they commit.
Nukeduck again, refreshing his blue buff. Secured his one a moment or two ago. And we're seeing these tanks get tankier. Steve has back to pick up that Righteous Glory and Spectre's Cal. Freddy got the makings of a Randian's Omen. This arms race continues to escalate.
Very extended laning phase here, and I feel Rocket should start looking to group. Put that Sivir to use. Use that on the hunt to your favor.
I feel like we've said that before, Krepo.
Maybe I did. Maybe my memory's a little fuzzy, you know? All these games of League of Legends.
We've seen a lot of Sivir, so it is the same story.
Yep. And SK, they're hovering out of the bot lane. Enraider defending his AD carry, and they can do that 2v1 because Rocket's not putting any pressure with their jungle support combo. And SK, they just want to take down his tower. That's what Candy Panda is so good at. Even into AoE wave clear. Just put the E on the tower a couple hits every time. Just want to whittle it down.
Very few champions that can take out towers as efficiently as Tristana. And something else they also have the option to do, if SK are able to push that top lane tower down, Cassio and Tristana could melt through Baron very quickly, but that is a while away. It looks like the pressure's on the bottom lane.
This might be what Rocket wants, because now they can group up at least. That on the hunt, double teleport in top lane. Both sides can cancel each other's teleport. However, Freddy still has ulti, so he can get his teleport stopped and then ulti out and says, see you later. Alligator. No Renekton so far. Thank God. Worst stats in the split so far.
Yep. One time.
And one time only.
Turned into a pair of shoes and won't be returning for a while, I expect. But yeah, look at the gold again. Krepo, you're pointing it on this side. Evened out. SK's lead is dwindling. That CS advantage that Fox and Freddy have built up is becoming less and less relevant. And it's just a matter of who makes a mistake? Who gets caught out? Rocket are playing so defensively.
This is what they did actually at the start of the split, or in some weeks where they had that very low pre-20 minutes activity. Not last week, but the week before that, they went 0-1-0, or yeah, 0-1-1 in the early game. Only one death. That's all they managed to acquire. They died once in two games before 20 minutes. So super passive play. And right now, not much more, honestly. We're 24 minutes into the game, 7 kills across the board, a couple of towers, a couple of dragons, but no action, no game plan. And usually when Rocket hits the late game after this, it's not like they're a phenomenal late game team.
Right. SK, on the other hand, slightly better at closing out once they get ahead, but they're not ahead. That's the thing I'd like to stress. We heard Candy Panda at the beginning of the game highlighting how they don't want to cosplay Fnatic. You could argue they could borrow a page out of Fnatic's book when it comes to decision making. This is trading, and maybe SK are going to play for Aspect of a Dragon. If that's the case, 2 minutes till the next one. Could be in for a slightly longer game, but...
yeah, since the first dragon went down so late, Aspect is still a whole time off. However, SK scales a little better, in my opinion, than Wokat. Crucial taunt flash could be enough to win these fights. And yeah, no grouping, no flanking on the side of Wokat.
And I still think if SK do get this top tower down, that Steve has been defending so exceptionally well, I feel that SK have a slightly bigger Baron threat. We'll expand on that idea in a minute. Steve's going to get jumped on. Time one, it goes out, and Steve's going to be able to just walk away. But to finish the point, I think a Cassiopeia and a Tristana, with their single target damage, could do very well if they can surprise Rocket. And you can see, look at the warding. Look at the deep vision. SK continue to pressure Rocket now on the top half of the map.
Both mid laners decently blue dependent, so that's the objective we see fought around quite often so far. Fenskin wants that blue buff. It's a help. Now he has Black Shield backing him up, so he can overextend a little bit. We see Sivir in the bot lane, so this might actually prompt an engage somewhere from SK Gaming.
Sven actually secured that one. Whether intentional or not.
Handy Panda heading back to bottom to deal with the Sivir push. This puts the move on Rocket's side. Are they going to group up finally?
Well, with 35 seconds to Dragon, you have to think pressure on the bottom half of the map is more advantageous, but with all the vision on the top half, Freddy can stay uncontested.
Look how chunked he is.
Oh, Candy Panda's in trouble. He's got Flash, he's got Heal,
oh,
but
he's
you
dead.
Cannot run away from the mine. Flash forward, but there's the Stand United. Freddy's coming in for the fight. Mr. Riles flashed in for that one. Turret is now secured. You didn't see whether Steve interrupted the Stand United or not, but it's not important as Freddy is now pushing that top lane.
And Candy Panda caught a little off guard, and I just went back and checked. Mr. Rawls, he had a spell shield available for that Tristana ulti. That could have been a clean kill for Rocket. A bit of a misplay on either side. I don't think Candy Panda should have stuck around, and I don't think Rawls should have got ulti back, but here we go.
Yeah. Team fight. Parallel Convergence stuns up two dragons down to 3,000, but Sven is chunked to half. There's no Candy Panda for a little while. Down to 2,000 HP on the dragon. Teleports up, but top laners are fighting. Rocket, they've got their first dragon of the game, as Sven Skiren will go down to Jankos. Dragon plus tower plus kill. Rocket are now in the lead, ever so slightly.
Yeah, good move by Jankos there. He knocks Sven Skiren out of the pit, then turns around, finishes the dragon. Because of that earlier move, when Freddy had to use his ultimate to save Candy Panda, who overextended, he lost a tempo. Rocket capitalized on that with a dragon, the tower two. So allows him to catch up, and this puts the Aspect of the Dragon 18 minutes away, and this is very, very deep into late game territory. So that almost is removed as a clean win condition from SK Gaming. So they need to find another way to close out this game. Likely around that Baron, as you said. Look at the vision right here, Trevor.
So the Baron pit is where SK have their vision. It's all in the deep half of, top half of the map. SK actually ran that vision in significantly earlier. And take a look at the Baron stats. 5 Barons to SK versus the 11 of Rocket. Rocket way more control in that area of the map. This game, however, I think SK have the advantage.
Yeah, it's similar length of game, so you would think a team with more Barons just has like very long games, but both teams like to play it slow. I can appreciate that. I understand where you're coming from.
And also, both teams don't necessarily get uber crushed when they lose. They both tend to dig quite deep. Well, let's see. Jankos is in trouble. He's going to get booted backwards. Going to flash and body slam away.
Actually, I lied when I said I appreciate it. I think he'd have guard meta game. You just have to be decisive, and neither team is all that decisive this game. Understandably so, you're playing the bottom parts of the ladder right now, and one victory almost counts as two, if that makes sense, because you get a victory and you deny your opponent one. Those matches that you play against the top teams like Fnatic, Origin, H2K, you don't really need to battle with them because you're already behind them in the standings. A victory here from SK against Rocket would mean so much more for them.
And for SK Gaming, if they lose this game, they will then be in sole possession of ninth place. With Gambit winning the previous matchup, Gambit is now out of the promotion tournament zone at 4-7. So for SK, it's very, very important. Rocket have got a tiny buffer more.
They're only one win ahead.
4-6.
So close.
SK even up that score if they pick up a win. But that's what Europe has become in summer. A top three, currently a bottom seven. But we're starting to see that filter and break down to it.
Now last week, we saw SK poise around the Baron. Ready, split pushing in the bottom lane. And it all went haywire. This week, however, double pink ward. Lots of single target DPS and Rocket.
They've got it.
Hello.
Kreppo, I don't know how many times we talked about the threat of Baron. Rocket misreading the situation. The team fight breaks out. Yangos is knocked away. Chain of Corruption did connect. They've got one kill down, two kills down. SK are in the advantage. They've only lost the slithering snake. That is Fox's Cassio. Mr. Rolls surrounded by three. He'll get one before getting taken out as the time winder will not connect on Steve. Baron plus three kills at the cost of two.
SK Gaming almost make the same mistake where they secure the objective and then try and chase for a fight for apparently no reason. Rocket barely make it out there, or barely die in the process right there. Let's watch that again. They burn down the dragon, or the Baron, but they choose to fight. I feel they could have just disengaged and let Freddy split push in the bottom and group up. If I was right in thinking so, yeah, they get Yankos. They could disengage right now. Kyle on him, and Raiden goes low. Let's keep our eyes on Wallace in this fight. He deals so much damage. Kills Fox, then he gets a threat from Svenskeren. He's playing 1v3 here, and Steve, I feel like if Steve didn't turn around to the right side, he could have cleaned up Enraid and Candy Panda here. That fight could have gone real ugly for SK Gaming, so they won, so in the end they were right, but really speaking in hindsight, I feel like Rocket could have almost cleaned up there. So SK again, a little too over-eager on the trigger.
Ends up working out this time around, and SK now the strongest gold lead we've seen all game long. Arguably not particularly massive, 3,000. Yankos and Vander, they're challenging for blue. I think Sven was able to smite that one away. Reading that correctly.
It'll become so hard right now for them to defend, though. Nuke Duck!
Sven is in trouble. Nuke connects with that chain of corruption, but he's being focused down. Nuke Duck is out as Candy Panda is going to have the reset. Fox will be killed on Rocket's side as Mr. Riles and Yankos are now split. This is getting messy. SK are all over the jungle. Svenskeren is phase diving in. Chrono breaking out. Time windering forward and trying to find Mr. Riles. Crucially, Mr. Riles is still alive and putting down the auto attacks. But it's not going to be enough for a 2-for-1 fight in favor of SK and their third tower of the game.
Svenskeren was everywhere that fight. Left, right, center, above the wall, back in. Beautiful use of gap closers by SK Gaming. And yeah, they just ran around Rocket until they were too dizzy to catch up and eventually died in the process. This was a good fight from SK Gaming. A lot more controlled, a lot better of a fight. And ooh, Baron buff helping. Look at the tower go down.
That satchel charge. Really putting the hurt down on that inner turret. SK, now with Baron, zero hesitation. The moment they got that Baron, they instantly set their sights in the mid tower, they picked a team fight, and they got both.
Well, to be fair, Rocket shot first. They went for Svenskeren and knocked him back, tried to kill him, but he stayed alive long enough and then received the Black Shield from Enraided. Allowed him to do enough damage, and suddenly Nuketuck found himself just killed in that fight immediately, and that was all SK needed. Once they were 5v4, zero hesitation, as you said, and looking for a fight and third dragon.
Something we haven't highlighted too much, which we will in a moment or two, is all of the physical damage that Rocket have to play with and the practically non-existent magic damage. All of the armor Sven and Freddy have put together means the poke from Nuke and Mr. Rolls is not that impressive. They're not the biggest tank killers. We'll explore that in a moment as SK pick up the third dragon, as it's Fox that actually poisons it down. Enraged engaged with the coin. Red's Medallion rather than trying to run in. And Dragon secured. Yankos, he's used the explosive cask on Freddy.
Steve wants to engage. Dredge line connects. Focus is still Freddy. Parallel Convergence will be on the back. Keep your eyes on Mr. Rolls. Will he be alive? Freddy is still alive. Now Svenskera is the focus. And it's just an awkward chain of events. Rocket can't finish the fight.
And I think you need to hit the nail on the head there, Trevor, with the itemization choices for SK Gaming here. Building so much armor, and this is why we said in the early game, or in the A block rather, you want to have double poke, and then you want magic damage on your top lane to fix that itemization gap, because double AD just doesn't work here in the late game for Rocket. And SK with the better scaling on top. Yanko's looking for a pick.
Skaren's a little bit in trouble. He's going to chronobake back to the lane. Chain of Corruption does catch him out, and Steve roots him down. Steve shuts down Svenskeren. But can Rocket take more?
Even though SK picked up the Baron, they're relatively low on wave clear here. Good grouping from Rocket. Finally, they're grouping together. Finally, they're using their composition. He finds the opening. SK tried to flank, but it didn't work out. And Rocket, they're clawing back in the game. Look at the top wave.
Tower number 4 secured. This could be tower number 5 if Rocket can get there quickly enough. They should. Varus and a Sivir, and that's going to close that gold lead back to 2,500 gold.
And SK, they desperately just want to go back to that moment in time where they have Freddy keeping Steve down in the side lane. This prevents the grouping. Rocket, all they need is one opening and then keep the pressure on SK Gaming. Don't let them fan out. Don't let them 4-1 or 1-3-1. Preventing your grouping.
Life's going to be a little more difficult for SK because Freddy actually teleported to that mid lane to defend it. Steve has TP, but of course it is a Shen. The Stand United's available.
Yeah, and Double Lost Whisper is out now too. So that almost too much 80 damage kind of gets reduced a little bit right now.
It's going to take a long time.
But still, it's going to be a lot of time to get through Freddy here. He's tanky. Rocket, they're cleaning these waves. While we said that fifth dragon, that aspect may not have been a clean win condition, SK might just settle for a dirty win condition. Take it down anyways.
A long way away from that. At least 3 minutes, I think, until dragon spawns, Crepo.
Baron won, though. And look at Freddy. He's in prime position again. Now Rocket, he had some time to group, didn't get anything done anymore because they had to base. They yielded the tempo to SK Gaming. Now Freddy's knocking on the top tower. Steve is dealing with bottom lane. Baron's about to come up, and suddenly SK is back in control of the game. You want to deward the Baron pit, force a potential fish tech, or just simply DPS down that Baron. Cassio and Tristana have so much damage.
Especially now. Voidstock and Hourglass for Fox. BT, Phantom Dancer, Eye Edge for Candy Pan and Tristana. Once he picks up Lost Whisper, it's going to be very scary for Rocket.
Yeah, and Freddy, he wants to base, go back to the bottom lane and do the same thing. So a minute from now, ideally, or a minute and a half, he wants that top wave, or that bottom wave, pushed all the way in. Keep Steve locked down. Put the pressure out. Scuttle Crab?
Svenskeren got
Svenskeren.
That one. Trying to read that little graphic as well. Yep, red vision
crucial
for SK. That's very important at this stage. But it is, of course, SK with the advantage of pushing that objective. We're waiting for the next dragon. Vision has been mixed throughout the game, but SK with a lot of deep wards as well.
And look at how Freddy's manhandling Steve right now. He's built 40 steam fights. He just wants to go in and soak up so much damage. He doesn't offer much resistance to Freddy.
Let's take a look. Where do SK set their sights? Baron is up. Vision, I'm gonna say, is even on both sides. There's a lot of wards top and bottom around that Baron buff. With 2 minutes before Dragon and the fact that Freddy's pushing the wave out, SK are going to have the option to peel back for Dragon number 4 if they want that over the Baron.
SK want to go for an initial vision clear right here. Wait for that Scuttlecraft to expire. Try to not get caught in the process. Baron, I choose you.
Cheeky Yankos.
But yeah, the Dragon and the Baron, that's what this game's about. Nobody's going to be knocking on any towers. Rocket want to find a pick. Remember they have On the Hunt? Here we go!
So On the Hunt is thrown down. Nuketak flashes forward. Chain of Corruption catches Fox. But here's the Stand United. Mr. Rolls, Spell Shield, the Petrifying Gaze. And Steve has teleported in. The Fox is down. And now Rocket only have one damage threat to deal with. They've set their sights on Svenskera. An explosive cask is available. And Rocket, pull the trigger, get the kill, and go to Baron.
What a play from Nuketak. And actually, this is one of the abilities I'm not sure on whether you can R flash instead of flash R, but it kind of looked like that because he flashed in first. Then sent out the Varus ultimate. Even though Fox flashed, he flashed in a straight panic line. He got down. Svenskin, he's looking for a steal.
Kask is available. Vengeful Maelstrom is available. 3,000 HP. Is this a 50-50 Baron? Svenskin's got Smite, Mr. Riles, and Rockout. They're dropping it. They're dropping it. They're looking for the steal. They're peeled away. Freddy has managed to pick up a kill. Baron seems to regenerating. They've traded support for top laner. Svenskin's running low on mana, and Rockout opt out of the Baron and back away. Even on kills, down 3,000 gold. We're cresting 40 minutes in game.
Oh my, I think Svenskin could have stolen that Baron, but he messed up his phase dive. He didn't get the initial jump over the wall because he wanted to jump over the wall, finish with that Baron that was on roughly 1.5, 1.8k HP. That could have been such a big steal here for SK Gaming. However, Baron is still alive. Dragon number 4, seemingly uncontested, going down.
Now, Freddy has teleport advantage as Steve jumped into that middle lane a few moments ago. We've seen some more item pickups. Thorn Mails for top laners, Bloodthirster completed for Riles, Lost Whisper for Candy Panda. So we're hitting max build.
Really like the Thorn Mail against double AD. It's such a potent item because damage return is calculated before your armor kicks in. So you take a very low amount of damage, but you turn a decent amount. Obviously, so Freddy very tanky, and it will actually become very hard for him to get killed. And these AD carries, they all have their work cut out for them on Rockhead's side. And they remember, the only way that happened was because Rockhead found a good opening on Fox. Hopefully, he's not going to fall for the same trick twice.
There's no flash engage from Nuketech this time around.
Look for on the hunt. They want to force a fight because nobody's defending against Freddy in the bot lane. We might see a panic Baron start and a 50-50 from Rockhead here. Things might get messy.
May get messy if SK engage. Let's see.
They want to hold him off.
Forward. Chain of Corruption does not connect.
Too obvious a play from Rockhead. They want to start the Baron just to start a fight. SK, they realize this. They have Black Shield. They have dashes on Svenskin. Look at the bottom. Hesitation is the seed of defeat when it comes to these Baron plays. SK, for once, playing calm.
And SK are the ones now going to put the pressure on Baron. Remember, they've got the ability to rush it down. Freddy will secure tower number 5 for SK to even it up with Rockhead. Rockhead are split. Baron will go down before Rockhead can contest. We see Stand United being channeled onto Enrated. He's zoning them away with Soul Shackle. Steve is in the middle of everyone with his Vengeful Maelstrom down. Where is Riles and Nukeduck? Candy Pender, he tops forward aggressively as Svenskin's on the back. There's no damage from Rockhead coming down. Steve and Yankos focus before Nukeduck and Riles can join the fight. Finally, they connect, and they will spread the Chain of Corruption, but it might be too little and too late. 2-for-1 and Baron to SK.
Finally, a decisive SK around the Baron here. They use the split push component in Freddy. Beautifully to their execution here. Yeah, good play by SK. They split up Rockhead. On the left side, we had double tank. On the right side, we had the damage that just couldn't reach over. Eventually, SK got through that BV tank line. Took them a while.
Oh, yes.
But they still died.
Warmog's now completed for Freddy as well. And here's a quick look. 4,139 HP with 330 armor. That yep. is a giant ninja.
No longer has to sneak through the shadows.
That's it.
That is it. But he's a ninja. Just a tanky one. Thank you, Trevor, for letting me hang in here.
I don't
Usually this is a duo cooperation, but I see how it is. Candy Panda, let's stay on focus here. Talking about who's a ninja and who's not. Candy Panda, 4-0-6 on Tristana here. First Tristana in the European summer split, rather. Yeah, it's working out for him.
It's like no pressure, really. Rockhead playing so defensive and so reactive. I think that's a better word for Rockhead's play. Waiting for SK to make a play and then trying to respond. And SK have got a lead at 9,000 as it's 44 minutes and they're sieging this mid turret.
In game one, we saw Maokai, he lost. Game two, we saw Maokai, he's losing. Obviously not always the case, correlation, causation and the like, but SK looking to take this victory home.
Any of the teams that watched that introduction to the show could have spurred on some thought and discussion. Losses are going to be the best of lessons, and SK 4-1. They're gonna get themselves on this inhibitor turret. Look at that satchel charge, massive explosion.
I like the use of Black Shield there on Tristana. He goes low though, however.
Well, let's see, on the Hunter's been used, Chain of Corruption goes wide and the Petrifying Gaze doesn't connect. Fox goes golden, stays alive, his Finn is forced to Chrono Break alive.
Steve?
Do you see Steve? He's gonna be able to get one onto Fox. We see Mr. Rolls dropping Candy Panda and the inhibitor stands. Piercing Arrow comes out, Dredge Line connects. Root holds Freddy down. Double kill for Rolls, 3-0.
SK Gaming with a greedy move. As I was saying, how I like the use of Black Shield to get that tower, then back the hell off. Because you just use your defensive summoner spells on your defensive Black Shield to get that tower. Be happy with it, back off and go in again later. Look at, they make use of that opening, and once Steve can connect with Fox, it's over for SK Gaming because they could just pound him, kill him immediately here, Vander. The Echoes both trying to tank this tower, get some resets. No longer slow, so easier to get out of there. Rawls is thanking for the mana, and Rocket looking for a clean inhibitor trade here.
And they
gets
will
just
get
a one tower. They lost.
20 seconds. Rocket greedy. The answer seems to be yes. They're on the next
greed?
Turret. 20 seconds for life. There's minions now conga lining in. Vander's taking a lot of damage. Sven Skeren's looking for Nuke Duck. The rest of Rocket seems to feel
backwards.
Nuke Duck's in trouble. Jankos is tanking up that Death Star laser and Sven gets knocked away. He Chrono Breaks back in, but it's Enrated that gets the kill. Sven looking for more. Parallel Convergence will not connect and Rolls spell shields the Dark Binding. So Rocket, Inhibitor, the turret, and Nexus turret at the cost of Jankos. They cannot challenge for Dragon, surely not.
And look at Freddy comes in. They want to keep Rawlis alive here.
Well, Rawlis is not really under threat yet. Vander, however, is. You can see Nuke Duck, he's peeled away. All of a sudden, Vander's in trouble. Candy gets the reset. Vander may be going down. I think he will. SK gonna chase Mr. Rawlis out. Freddy's zoning away. Gonna throw down that Vorpal Blade. Shadow Dash. Shadow Dash. Shadow Dash. Shadow Dash.
Any time up.
Oh, he's
here. We go.
That was just cheating. Inhibitor secured. Now is this game?
Very OP game, however.
No minion.
Still alive on Nuke Duck. SK can back off and seal the victory in anyways with that dragon. A beautiful move initially by Rocket. They take the inhibitor. They hesitate, take the tower. They should have focused Fence Screen down because that would have given them tempo on the map, 4 against 5, but they didn't think ahead enough. They forgot about the dragon. And people obviously forget about Dre. It wasn't enough.
Now, we posed the question, Crepo.
Was it greedy? Checkbox, yes. Yes, it was.
For the second time, no, the third time this
fourth,
split.
Fourth, I think, even.
I think it's the third time its aspect has been hit.
I will double check.
We shall. Spellzy, let us know. Behind the scenes stats guy. SK had been denied it previously.
Doesn't matter how many times it happens, it just
matters that it does.
Matters that it does for SK Gaming right here. However, we are very late in the game and aspect will be enough for SK. They almost overreached at the cost of the game earlier on that inhibitor. Eventually, Rocket, they caught the ball and then they threw it back.
Well, we have to highlight, Freddy's picked up a Blade of the Rune King on Shen after selling his Wit's End.
I like it. Good adaptation.
Gonna make Baron threat even more real in a
just
minute.
Just a split push. He can now stick to the enemy AD carry. They can't even afford to hit him. We saw Rawlis, usually you can stutter step and carry backwards with your auto attacks, but he can't do that against the Thornmail because he'll take more damage than he lifesteals. So he had to resort to hitting the Krugs.
So there are super minions doing battle with super minions in the middle lane. So that at least will keep Rocket a little bit of time. And we just heard from Spellzy, this is in fact the fourth time the fifth dragon has...
I'd like to announce to the audience that this was Crepo, right, with the statistics.
Hashtag Crepo is right.
As always.
Oh, we do see...
Okay, Black Shield used.
Now, oh! A lot of damage onto Candy Panda.
Doesn't work against physical poke. Deny the engage, but Rocket, they were hoping for SK to make the same mistake twice. Use a Black Shield to get the tower and then get flash twisted advanced on by Steve. The Aspect not being used because there's not much poke on SK Gaming. Aspect is so good because if you have AoE damage, everybody gets that damage over time. However, single target Cassiopeia to an extent, very small zones of AoE damage, and Candy Panda. Fox is soloing Baron.
Why not? I think he's going to need some help.
He's going to get his help.
He's got the help. And we do see Baron's going to get secured here. I've just been informed that Freddy has actually dealt double the damage to champions than Fox this game. That front line sticking to Rocket has really been paying off. Also, the 27 years of fighting a giant tree is also going to help pad those stats a little bit.
Steve will never die, right? So you can just keep hitting him, Maybe they made a gentleman's agreement to buff up their stat lines.
Freddy's just barking up the wrong tree and winning in the statistical category. Aspect of the Dragon, Baron, 12,000 gold leaves, exposed inhibitor. Surely SK can close this game out if they do not make a positional mistake or an engage mistake.
I mean, history will repeat itself and SK will show if they've learned from their mistakes right here. Good usage of the Black Shield on the push, I like it. Keep your AD carry alive. However, there's so much offensive engage from Rocket. Remember, they're running a Sivir comp with Maokai. They can get through your carries.
We'll find out whether Rocket can find the carries. Tower's being focused, Satchel Charge comes out. Sven is gonna get caught by the Chain of Corruption and it will spread
Kales is
to
used.
Fox. On the Hunter's not been used, now it has. Mr. Rolls is trying to get auto attacks onto Freddy, but this is not the target you're looking for. Sven Skirin puts down the parallel convergence and Rocket, you're fighting on the wrong side of the objective, man. Rocket are gonna lose another inhibitor, as their mid inhibitor will be respawning in the not too distant future. SK, peel backwards.
Control aggression by SK and good use of zone control with the parallel conversions. As you said, forcing Rocket to play at the wrong side of the objective. One inhibitor goes down. One was already down. One is remaining. SK looking to take on that final inhibitor. But Baron buff. Yeah, slightly over halfway. And then that wave clear from Mr. Rouse and Nuketuck will kick in again, so. Okay, looking to hang on.
Itemization, of course. Essence Reaver picked up by Nuketuck on Varus. More lifesteal, more CDR. Reduce to the engage. Explosive cost doesn't connect. There goes the depth charge. Sven Skirin gets knocked out, but Freddy's in behind everybody. He's got five members of Rocket to fight. And that's what cost Rocket earlier. The tanks up front, the damage behind. Empowered recalls, SK get out, but they've got the bottom inhibitor and middle will respawn shortly.
Yeah, and Jankos was trying to break that black shield. Allow his explosive cast to knock Candy Panda into his team. Just didn't have the damage to do so. Could have been brutal for SK Gaming. Look at the top left of the screen. Talk about Aspect. 1 minute, 15 seconds away from spawning. And Rocket, they want to group up right now and deny the split push from Freddy. 45 seconds. Crucial point in the game. They want that inhibitor for the added pressure. They need that mid wave to cancel out the pressure that they get in the bot wave. Mid lane inhibitor spawn for them. Baron almost out.
So let's see whether or not Rocket can secure this objective. 30 seconds they have to play with a numbers advantage. And Crepo, about half an hour ago, we said Aspect of the Dragon could be a thing. Second Aspect of a Dragon could be a thing. Jankos is going to zone away Sven, as that's a very easily secured inhibitor. Pressure is still on.
Channeling their inner Meron and Pippin. We've had first Aspect. How about second Aspect? But yeah, they're looking for that additional damage because they're having a hard time closing it. We talked about how Maokai is weaker when behind. Good check here. Sven Skirin gets caught.
Well, let's see. Chain of Corruption not going to spread to anybody. It's not the longest of cooldowns. Vanda is still very, very tanky.
Down.
That's a 3,200 hit point support tank Nautilus. But Rocket have been pushed away from the Dragon.
Look at the deep wards from Rocket. They want to catch them off guard with a teleport behind. Steve might be picking up home guards because there's no other reason for him to walk to the fountain. He got a home guards. He's looking for a teleport. Might see an explosive fight right here.
There was a ping on that Tribush ward as well.
On the hunt.
Here's the teleport. Steve, where can he find a target? Gonna try jump onto Fox. Not gonna find it. Fox has flashed away. We see a chrono break from Sven. This is a little messy from SK, but messy's not too bad. We see petrifying gaze, locks up the damage. Rocket continue to fire down. Freddy is out, but we see Sven taking down Steve. SK continuing to try to retreat. The Chain of Corruption catches Enrated, and Rawls and Nuketuck are still alive. Candy Panda
kills him. Triple kill.
Triple. Nuketuck's gonna look for the Quadra. Can he get it? He does! Quadra kill for Nuketuck! 5-4!
What a fight! And look at the death timers! Only one Nexus turret is remaining! This may be the victory for Rocket!
If Nuketuck can finish the game within the next minute, he will not set a new record for the longest game in Summer Split.
Look at the player camps, absolutely distraught on SK side, and look at how happy Jankos is. He's waiting to jump out of his seat. He tells, no, okay, referee, I'm sitting down. What a game!
For the fifth time this split, Rocket are victorious!
Almost.
Eventually.
Oh, yes, they are.
Holy shit. What the fuck?
What a game.
The smiles are real.
Usually, when I leave a long game, I leave with an inkling of disappointment. But this game was fun. This game was exciting. Wasn't the best strategy. Went back and forth, but yeah. Fantastic how Rocket managed to stay in there. And honestly, some of the same mistakes from SK Gaming as we saw last week. Hesitation. One time they were decisive and they got so much out of it, but then they started hesitating. And they overreached. They tried to get both tower and inhibitor in one push, and that is simply greedy. Greed is not good.
It's definitely not. Rocket managed to survive, managed to pick up another win, and put more distance away from the bottom half of the table. For SK, I think the Cassiopeia is the only thing I'm a little questionable about that pick, because what we saw throughout the game is Fox was only putting damage to the tanks. He never really got to nuke duck and rolls. The range and the inability to get past that front line. It's what we saw last week from Cassio, and it's what we continue to see.
I would argue with that, because honestly, SK was in prime position to win this game. They made a couple key mistakes that allowed Rocket to come back, but they had the superior, like, I guess early late game to an extent, where they had a lot of damage, but then eventually once you hit the six-sided point where the Steve just gets so tanky that it takes too long for SK to burn through them, because let's not forget, Steve was very, very behind in the early game. He was put